Hello friends, I am Dr. Sarika Panwar. I welcome you all in the lectures of Information Theory, Coding and Communication Network, that is the subject of third year ENTC. Today we will solve the numericals based on discrete memoryless channels, in which we have to find the various entropies and mutual information. This example is asked in question paper of Pune University, that is SPPU, in March 18 for 6 marks. What is the example? A discrete memoryless channel, DMC means discrete memoryless channel, having the transition matrix, that is channel matrix, as 0.6, 0.4, 0.4, 0.6, emits equiprobable messages X1 and X2. Draw the channel diagram and find HX, HY, H of X over Y, that is the conditional entropy, and mutual information, that is I of X, Y. Comment on type of channel. Now what we have to find, what is given, that is important in this numerical. We are given with the transition matrix, that is the channel matrix, and two input symbols, probabilities are actually given. How it is given? Because they have given one statement that the discrete memoryless channel emits two symbols X1 and X2 with equal probabilities, because these are two equiprobable messages emitted by the discrete memoryless channel. We have to draw the channel diagram and we have to find this entropy HX, HY, H of X over Y and mutual information, and also we have to comment on type of channel. Okay, so what is the given matrix? Transition matrix is given, that is probability of capital Y over X. It is nothing but our channel matrix, transition matrix, and that is equal to 0.6, 0.4, 0.4 and 0.6. It is emitting two equiprobable messages X1 and X2. Equiprobable messages means probability of X1 is 0.5 and probability of X2 is also 0.5. These two equiprobable messages are transmitted and we receive Y1 and Y2. That is given to us. Okay. So, from this transition matrix, we can say that this is the probability of Y1 over X1. That is probability of receiving Y1 when X1 is transmitted. So, probability of receiving Y1 when X1 is transmitted is 0.6. Probability of receiving Y2 when X1 is transmitted. Probability of receiving Y2 when X1 is transmitted is 0.4. Probability of receiving Y1 when X2 is transmitted, that is 0.4. And probability of receiving Y2 when X2 is transmitted is 0.6. This is given to us. Okay. Now, first we will draw the channel diagram. Definitely, this is the binary channel. Why? Because it is emitting two symbols. That way we can say that it is binary channel, which is emitting two equiprobable messages X1 and X2. These are the two equiprobable messages and we are getting Y1 and Y2. What is the probability of getting Y1 and when X1 is transmitted? It is 0.6. So here we can write 0.6. What is the probability of getting Y2 when X1 is transmitted? It is given as 0.4. What is the probability of getting Y1 when X2 is transmitted? Y1 when X2 is transmitted is also 0.4. And probability of getting Y2 when X2 is transmitted is 0.6. Now, when these two probabilities are same, 0.6, 0.6, it is a binary symmetric channel. This is binary symmetric channel. That's what we can comment. Binary symmetric channel. This is a binary symmetric channel that we can conclude. Okay. So, initially we will find this h of x and h of y. For finding h of x, we will write the equation for h of x, capital X. We know that is the entropy of this input symbol. Why? Because it is capital H of X. So that two symbols are there. So it will be summation from X is equal to 1 to 2. So it will be probability of X1 into log to the base 2, 1 over probability of X1 plus probability of X2 log to the base 2, 1 over probability of X2. So what is probability of X1? It is 0.5 because these are equiprobable messages. So 0.5 into log to the base 2, 1 over 0.5 plus probability of X2 is also 0.5. So 0.5 into log to the base 2, 1 over 0.5. Okay. So answer is 1 bit per message. H of x, entropy we find in bits per message. So h of x is 1 bit per message. Now we will find h of y, that is output entropy. Output entropy formula is h of y is equal to probability of y1 log to the base 2, 1 over probability of y1 plus probability of y2 log to the base 2, 1 over probability of y2. Okay, why? Because there are two symbols. Now, what is probability of y1? That is the output probability. Now, for finding probability of y1 and probability of y2, we have to use the channel matrix. Now, how we will use this channel matrix for finding probability of y1 and y2? Again, we will write channel matrix here. It is 0.6, 0.4, 0.4 and 0.6. Okay. This is y1 and y2. This is x1 and x2. Okay. Now, what is this? This is the probability of getting y1 when x1 is transmitted. So, for probability of y1, this equation we have already discussed in our last video, that probability of getting output y1, that will be equal to this probability into input probability. Means probability of y1 over x1 into input probability x1 plus probability of getting this output, that is y2 over x1, y2 over x1 into probability of x1. This equation will give us the output probability. What is y1 over x1? It is 0.6 into input probability 0.5 plus y2 over x1, it is 0.4 into input probability, it is 0.5. If you solve this equation, you will get input output probability P of y1 is equal to 0.5. Okay. Now, next is output probability, probability of y2. Okay. Now, for this, you have to consider these two probabilities. Okay. So, probability of y1 when x2 is transmitted, that is 0.4 into probability of x2. Probability of getting y1 when x2 is transmitted into input probability x2 plus probability of getting y2 when x2 is transmitted into probability of x2. That is equal to 0.4 into probability of x2, it is 0.5 प्लस 0.6 इंटू 0.5. सो दिस कम्स आउट टू बी 0.5. सो प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ वाई टू इट इज ऑल्सो 0.5. सो वी गॉट दिस टू टर्म्स. नाउ प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ वाई वन वी गॉट विद दिस इक्वेशन. प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ वाई टू वी गॉट विद दिस इक्वेशन. एंड नाउ वी कैन फाइंड एच ऑफ वाई. नाउ एच ऑफ वाई पुट इन दिस फॉर्मूला एच ऑफ वाई दैट इज प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ वाई वन इट इज 0.5 इंटू लॉग टू द बेस टू 1/0.5 प्लस अगेन दिस इज 0.5 एंड दिस इज 0.5 सो प्लस 0.5 इंटू लॉग टू द बेस टू 1/0.5. सो इफ यू सॉल्व दिस यू विल गेट एच ऑफ वाई इज इक्वल टू 1 bit पर मैसेज. सो वी गॉट दिस आंसर ऑल्सो. एच ऑफ एक्स वी गॉट एज 1 bit पर मैसेज एंड एच ऑफ वाई ऑल्सो 1 bit पर मैसेज. दीज टू टर्म्स वी गॉट नाउ एच ऑफ एक्स एंड एच ऑफ वाई. नाउ नेक्स्ट टर्म वी विल फाइंड इज एच ऑफ एक्स ओवर वाई दैट इज द कंडीशनल एंट्रोपी. वॉट इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर कंडीशनल एंट्रोपी? H of x over y is equal to summation from I is equal to 1 to n, summation from j is equal to 1 to n, probability of xi over yj that is the joint probability into log to the base 2 1 over probability of xi by yj. That is the formula for conditional entropy which we have already discussed, and for this we need these two terms. Probability of xi yj that is the conditional probability and this is joint probability and this is conditional probability. Now this matrix, this is actually probability of y by x. And we want, for this we want probability of, this is probability of x over y. So that is exactly opposite, okay? So now, initially, we will find the joint probability, that is probability of x comma y. Okay? And what is this? This is probability of x into probability of y over x. This is already given with us and this is also given to us. Okay, so now what we will do, just multiply this matrix with the input probabilities, that is 0.6 means this value, multiply it with 0.5, then this value that is 0.4, multiply it with the input probability that is 0.5, then this value again 0.4, multiply it with 0.5 because equiprobable messages are there and that's why all two values are probability of x1 and x2 both are same, that is 0.5, and now this value 0.6 multiplied by 0.5, so answer is 0.3, 0.2, 0.2 and 0.3. That is the answer. Okay. So this is the probability of x comma y. Now this will be probability of x1 y1. This is probability of x1 y2 because this is x1 and this is y1 y2. This is x2, y1, y2. So this is probability of x2, y1 and this is probability of x2, y2. Okay. Now from this we can get the joint entropy, that is h of x, y. What is the formula of joint entropy? It is summation from I is equal to 1 to N, summation from J is equal to 1 to M, probability of Xi comma Yj, that is the joint probability, log to the base 2, 1 over probability of Xi comma Yj, that is also the joint probability. So now there will be four terms because two summations and zero summation is from 1 to 2. That's why there will be total four terms, that is probability of x1 comma y1 into log to the base 2, 1 over probability of x1 comma y1 plus probability of x1 comma y2 log to the base 2, 1 over probability of x1 comma y2. Now you have to remember that the joint probability which you consider here, the same will be in the denominator, plus probability of x2 comma y1 log to the base 2, 1 over probability of x2 comma y1 plus probability of x2 comma y2 into log to the base 2 plus probability of x2 comma y2 log to the base 2, 1 over probability of x2 comma y2. So now if you put this for values, probability of x1 y1 is 0.3 log to the base 2, 1 over 0.3 plus this is x1 y2, that is 0.2 log to the base 2, 1 over 0.2, this is again 0.2 x2 y1, 0.2 log to the base 2, 1 over 0.2 plus 0.3 log to the base 2, 1 over 0.3. So if you put this values, we will get h of x comma y as 1.9706 bits per message. Now next part we have to find is h of x over y, that is the conditional entropy. Conditional entropy formula, again I will write for you. Summation from I is equal to 1 to N, summation from J is equal to 1 to M, and in conditional entropy, here we want the joint probability Xi comma Yj into log to the base 2, 1 over probability of Xi over Yj. But now we don't have this term, probability of Xi over Yj. How to find that term? We know that conditional probability formula, probability of Xi over Yj is equal to probability of Xi comma Yj, that is the joint probability divided by probability of Yj. We have this matrix already. It is this matrix, it is 0.3 0.2 0.2 0.3, divided by probability of Yj, this matrix is 0.5 0.5. So divide this matrix with this one, so each term of this will be divided by 0.5 because probability of y1 and y2 are again same. So now this is 0.3 divided by 0.5, then 0.2 divided by 0.5, 0.2 divided by 0.5, and 0.3 divided by 0.5. So answer will be 0.6, 0.4, 0.4, 0.6. Okay, so we got this answer for conditional probability matrix Xi over Yg. Okay, now from this we can calculate, means this is X1 over Y1, this is X1 over Y2, because this is X1, Y1, sorry, X1, X2 and Y1, Y2. So X1 over Y1 is this, X1 over Y2 is this, X2 over Y1 is this and X2 over Y2 is this. So now from this we can find the joint entropy H of X over Y. What is the formula of joint entropy H of X over Y? It is probably summation from I is equal to 1 to N, summation from J is equal to 1 to M, probability of Xi comma Yj, that is the joint probability, log to the base 2, 1 over probability of Xi over Yj. And now this matrix we got. Okay. So with this now, what we can get? This is, this matrix also we know, it is the joint probability matrix and this is the conditional probability matrix. Okay. So probability of Xi Yj, that is 0.3. So 0.3 into 1 over Xi Yj is 0.6. That is log to the base 2. 1 over 0.6 plus this is Xi Yj, it is 0.2. X1 Y2, it is 0.2. 1 over this term is 0.4 plus, now this one is 0.4 log to the base 2, 1 over 0.2 plus this is 0.3 log to the base 2, 1 over 0.6. So if we solve this equation, we will get, if we solve the equation of joint entropy H of X over Y, we will get 0.9706 bits per message. Final point we have to find is the I of XY, that is the mutual information. I of XY can be expressed, mutual information can be expressed in terms of conditional entropy, and that is H of X minus H of X by Y. This we have discussed in our previous video. That is one of the property of mutual information. H of X we have already calculated, that is 1 bit per message. Minus H of X over Y we have recently calculated, that is 0.9706. It is equal to minus 0.9706 bits per message. So answer is 0.0294 bits. That is the mutual information. This is how we can find all the values of Hx, Hy, conditional entropy H of X over Y and mutual information X, Y step by step. Thank you, students.